FM News. On point. A quick look at the news. I'm Lynn Komjisha. The Uganda Episcopal Conference has cautioned security agencies against excessive force on civilians and political players during campaigns. The chairman, Right Reverend Bishop Joseph Anthony Ziwa, while delivering the bishop's Christmas message, said Christmas has come during the political season, calling for tolerance to avoid violence. He condemns the violence which has characterized campaigns, especially as police disperses opposition meetings.
On behalf of the Catholic Bishops of Uganda, wish everyone a blessed Christmas and a happy New Year. In Uganda, this year's Christmas falls within the political campaigns. It is, however, sad to note that in the last few months, our country has already witnessed high level of violence leading to loss of life and property. We are concerned by the high-handedness of some security agents in handling opposition candidates and their supporters.
The bishops have also asked the Electoral Commission to intensify voter education and guarantee peaceful elections.
We call upon everybody to observe the rule of law and exercise their civic rights to associate and vote in a peaceful and respectable manner. We therefore call upon the Electoral Commission, we appeal, and all stakeholders in the electoral process to ensure that the elections are peaceful, free, and fair. The Electoral Commission should intensify voter education to enable all voters effectively cast their ballots on the polling day.
Journalists through various umbrella organizations have warned the public on the new coronavirus strain that has invaded Africa from UK. The Uganda Journalists Association President Mathias Rukundu noted during a joint meeting against the virus from the association's office in Kawempe that it is necessary for the public to observe SOPs since the new variant is highly transmissible. He also used the same meeting to reject the announced registration of journalists by the media Council to cover elections.
We need a free space for media. We want you to be in shape so that you dress well, that we can listen to you. We want to make it to you again that unless you engage us, assess the responsibilities that you have before trying to enforce just a small section of the act. We want to say that we condemn all the approaches in the strongest terms possible, and we want to commit before you journalists that we will champion the fight against these approaches.
The Entertainment Journalists Body, EJAL, President Herbert Chewalyanga Habke, also a COVID-19 survivor, used the same occasion to warn journalists against the virus while in the line of duty.
What started as 2020 is now 20 terrible. But of course, we know that it is not the end of the world. We can still live. All we have to do is try and do what the scientists and the medical workers are telling us to do, which is a new normal, and I'm very certain we can actually work around it. Put on our face masks, wash our hands regularly, make sure we social distance.
In sports news, the Confederation of African Football has cancelled the Confederation Cup first-round game between AS Kigali and Kampala Capital City Authority Football Club. The development was confirmed today in a letter addressed to the Ugandan club by the Football Governing Board in Africa. The reason for the cancellation of the match is that the Kasasiro boys failed to raise the recommended minimum number of players needed for a CAF game to take place after a number of its players tested positive for COVID. Therefore, according to CAF COVID-19 regulations, KCCFC has lost the match 2-0 as they failed to raise the minimum number of players, 11 players and 4 substitutes. KCCFC will now head into the second leg in Kampala next year with a 2-0 deficit. In other news, a new mutant strain of coronavirus has entered Britain from South Africa. Ministers revealed today as they plunged millions more families into Tier 4 from Boxing Day. Health Secretary Matt Hancock told the remaining parts of the southeast not already in the toughest level. They would be in it little more than 48 hours from now. He broke the news in a press conference this afternoon after sage experts revealed the coronavirus R rate in Britain linked to an existing new variety of COVID has risen to between 1.1 and 1.3. The outbreak of the new variant of COVID is spreading fastest in London and the east of England, where the R could be as high as a shocking 1.5, and it is at least one or higher in every region of England, except the northeast and northwest. A second new strain linked to South African arrivals has been identified in the UK, and Mr. Hancock said all flights from the nation had been halted. The variant, now known as B117, has spread like wildfire across the capital and home counties, and is thought to be on track to become the main version of coronavirus circulating in the UK. In entertainment news, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are emulating the Obama's successful business model and will move on to creating a book next. But it won't be a tell-all on the royal family. According to a royal expert, royal commentator said having a publishing deal is likely to be the next step for the Duke and Duchess of Sussex after they recently announced their actual audio podcast with Spotify, which followed a deal with Netflix. Since leaving the White House in 2016, Barack and Michelle Obama revealed a similar business route, with the couple announcing a Netflix deal with their company Higher Ground Productions, and soon after, a Spotify podcast. President Barack Obama launched his memoir, A Promised Land, in November, while his wife Michelle released her biography, Becoming, in 2018. Meghan could strike a book deal next. That was the news. XFM News. On point.